Hi, and welcome to the Unquendo Guitars Workshop. My name is Daniel, and Christmas came a bit early this year. I've ordered a bunch of guitar parts and new tools, and I thought, why not share the unboxing with you guys? So grab yourself a cup of hot chocolate, and let's start unpacking all these presents. Before every guitar build, I order all the hardware required for that guitar so I can do measurements and do test fittings on the actual instrument and don't run into any surprises. And this time I've ordered so much, I don't even recall what I've ordered. So let's start unpacking the smallest box first. And what do we have? Mystery package. Yeah, 6 spools of AWG22 hookup wire to do all the electronics in my guitars. And this should last me pretty long. And yeah, nice little set I found on the internet on a Dutch website. So I don't have any links, unfortunately, but here's the brand. So maybe you can look them up yourself if you're interested. On to the next box. A box from TLC Guitar Goods, and I really can't remember what I've ordered from them. Yeah, as always, a handwritten card from Alex. Thanks for your order. Have fun with your new tools. A new bottle of tight bond glue, some fretboard oil. I finally ran out of my Crimson guitar fretboard restorative oil, so I thought let's give this a try. I really can't remember. Oh yeah! A Precision router base from TLC to replace my homemade one, finally. Yeah, I think these are a couple of pickup screws, pickup ring screws, yeah, in black. I'll do a close-up later. Another bag of tiny screws. I love the paper packaging, it's awesome. Instead of having plastic packaging, just paper, you can just throw it in the recycle bin and you're done. Nice black real metal pickup rings. I wanted a lot of stuff. Okay. 2 sets of Grom metal pickup rings as well. There should be 2 sets, I believe. Yeah, 2 sets pickup rings. There's even more. Output jack. A black output jack, black 3-way switch, a lot of stuff, and just a Grom regular 3-way switch. There's even more. Nope, that's it. So let's put this stuff aside and let's open another box. which one to open next. This one, I think. Old ukulele box, I think. Let's see what's in it. Plastic. Plastic. Oh, nothing. First thing is nothing special, just some string stoppers, string ferrules for the back of the guitar. Of course, my preferred hardtail bridges, a hip shot hardtail bridge. Yeah. Nice bridge. Perhaps the best bridges out there. Two new truss rods. And another set of string ferrules. That's it already. Big box, not much in it. Let's open another one. The Tommen one next. Remove the packaging clip. And let's open up this one. Paper. Oh. Yeah, I think you can see it. It's a box filled with Fishman products. Black modern Fluence pickups. And these are the metal ones, not the plastic ones. A set of Tosin Abasi signature Fluence pickups in chrome. Always also nice packaging from Fishman. Everything's included. Couple of GrafTech Tusk nuts. And these days I started using the battery pack so the guitars will be chargeable by USB. So that's one. And here's the other. So here's the battery pack and the USB charge point. And it should come, of course, with instructions, the wiring required, and of course, a USB charger. Let's continue. Package from UPS, or at least sent by UPS. And this should be a package sent to me by Schaller. And this is a package from Schaller. And just to be clear, I'm not sponsored or affiliated by any of the brands seen in this video. I also have to order my parts and my tools and have to pay for them like any other. If you're interested in some affiliated links, they're always in the video description down below. Let's open this package somehow. Yeah, it's glued shut. And this is the first time I'm ordering directly from Charlotte. So I'm very curious about the content. Delivery notes. Where to start? Let's start with the little bag. Oh yeah, I forgot about those. One, just one. It appears I'm missing some stuff, but yeah, I ordered a black chrome pickup ring and I thought I'd ordered two, but apparently I only ordered one, and just a real metal black pickup ring, and I thought I'd order a couple just to see what they are and to try these out. Of course, some regular black dome knobs, some chrome ones, the Schaller S-locks to go on both the guitar and my custom leather straps. And now for the fun part, these boxes. Let's clear the table a little. Let's open up the first one. And I really also love this packaging from Schaller. Nice, luxurious packaging. I thought for the coming two guitar builds to switch out the Spurzel tuners I usually use to the Schaller locking tuners. And look at those. Real tiny knob on the back. They look absolutely stunning. Let's open another one. Also the same tuners, only black this time, and I think by now you can guess the theme of the two upcoming builds. Real nice, real tiny locking tuners. They feel great. And the final box. It's a Lockmeister tremolo bridge in black. Look at it. Wow, heavy. Correct block already installed. That's the nice thing about ordering directly from Schaller. You can order your tremolos customer specific, so you can select the block length you want and also the width of the locking nut, which should be in here somewhere. string tee, all black posts, and an R3 locking nut. So this is the 43 millimeter wide locking nut instead of the standard 42 millimeter locking nut. Some sets of Allen keys, the springs, and where did they hide the arm? Oh, here it is. An all black tremolo arm, whammy bar. So yeah, I'm really happy with this bridge. Can't wait to install it. So let's put all these goodies aside and let's open the final mystery package, the big black box. I'm really excited. It's a new tool. I bought myself a new piece of machinery to be used here in the workshop. Something I wanted to buy for a long time now, and I finally did. It's Christmas, so why not buy a present for yourself once in a while? Another box. Shipping note. Oh, there's a lot of loose stuff. These might give you a clue what's inside the big box. I have to be careful, there are some loose items. A bit of the packaging got broken. Nothing special, these are just some polishing discs. It's real heavy. But here we are. I've bought myself the Proxon FET miniature table saw. And if you've seen my previous videos when I made jigs, for example, I always mention I don't have the space here in the workshop for a table saw. So I bought a miniature one. But the main reason I bought this table saw is I'm going to try and convert it into a fret slotting saw. So yeah, let's open the rest of this box. Knife. All the plastic. Let's see inside. Of course, a manual. A All the accessories are on the top. Push stick. A fence, I think. Another part of the fence, and although it's miniature, I'm hoping that the Proxxon brand will be somewhat precise and somewhat good quality. And yeah, by the looks of this part, I think I might be lucky. This might be the guard. Bit of plastic, yeah, and the guard, as to be expected, nothing much. But of course, for a fret slotting saw, I'm not going to need the guard. A miter gauge, or whatever you call it, well, bit plasticky, but not a lot of play. And yeah, who knows, it might be useful. Some Allen keys. I think it's a vacuum adapter and a stopping block to go on the fence. Let's try and find the machine. Ooh, it's very oily. Very oily. Let's clean it before I'm covered in oil. Yeah, and of course I'm going to do a separate video on this little Proxxon table saw and show you how I try to convert it into a fret slotting machine. So at first glance, it seems decent enough, reasonable quality. It's nice and heavy, a solid machined piece of aluminum for the table. And yeah, of course the rest is plastic, but it doesn't feel too cheap. So yeah, and I'm going to make sure, of course, to make a separate video on the Proxxon FET table saw. And here is all the stuff I ordered the last couple of weeks, and I know it might seem a bit excessive, but especially for the guitar parts, I always order all my parts before I start a new guitar build, just to make sure I can check any dimensions, do some alignment checks, test fits, you name it. So I think it's very important to have all your parts at hand while building a guitar, just to make sure you don't run into any surprises during final assembly. That said, this is the end of this video, unfortunately, but hold on, before you click on your next video, I really want to thank you all for the support in the last year. I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I intend to spend the coming 2 weekends with friends and family, so there won't be any new Unguendo Guitars videos until the start of January next year, of course. So Yeah, if you like this video, let me know by leaving a like, leave a comment in the comment section down below, and I hope to see you all in the new year. But until then, have a Merry Christmas.